Assalamu alaikum. Hello guys, this is Aklan from Crypto Crazy. Here are the four main points you need to be aware of regarding Bitcoin's likely decrease in the future. Bitcoin is an unprofitable bubble. Owners of Bitcoin have no hope of future wealth. It's highly likely that after miners go extinct, the value of Bitcoin would zero out because there are no anticipated dividends, reverse dilutions or buybacks that would generate future profits for investors. First of all, kindly hit the subscribe button. It will motivate me to make more videos. Consider investing in a promising early stage business that develops over time and eventually pays dividends to shareholders once it is large enough to do so. In contrast to Bitcoin, which has only fueled speculation as of late, this company offers a direct service to clients while still having real-world utility. It should go without saying that the decentralized ledger technology at the heart of Bitcoin is incredibly valuable and groundbreaking. This aspect, however, does not give it a competitive edge over the many other cryptocurrencies that have a developed real-world exchange market and far higher potential for long-term gains for investors. Currently, there are a ton of different tokens in the crypto sphere that have a good chance of surpassing and displacing Bitcoin in the future. Let's say Ethereum. Ethereum will destroy Bitcoin. Since Ethereum is inherently flexible, it has tremendous real-world potential, a lot more than can be stated for Bitcoin. The Ethereum blockchain provides a programmable platform for smart contracts, dApps, and protocols that solve real-world issues and perform valuable services. The active use function of Ethereum and its native token Ether is to replace the wide range of obsolete accounting and banking services that the conventional finance system currently charges passive consumers roughly $3 trillion annually. Currently, Ethereum is generating about 0.05% of the total amount of money that may be taken from the Tradify ecosystem. It would cost about $40,000 per token if we estimate that it can only capture 0.5% of total fiat profits. Unlikely Bitcoin, this would be accomplished by practical uses of its utility rather than passively hoping to be realized as an alleged store of value or as a legal form of exchange. Michael Saylor or Robert Breedlove, two of Bitcoin's most lauded advocates, will shout about the currency's unchangeable worth until they turn red in the face. One of their main defenses is that Bitcoin serves as a store of value. Is it really? If you compare Bitcoin with gold, with half of gold supply going to jewelry, a tenth to industry, and a quarter being utilized as central bank reserves. Gold has a wide range of industrial applications. It operates as a store of value through a number of resilient and anti-fragile techniques. Maintaining this status even after being cut off from modern money in 1971. Bitcoin's real value is artificially inflated. The increase in the price of Bitcoin has concealed the fact that it has not yet been accepted as a legitimate form of payment. This has generated enough wealth for many people to join the Bitcoin hype train before any practical usefulness has been offered. Bitcoin's price fluctuation has virtually little to do with its actual usefulness. The increase in the price of Bitcoin is just a fictitious inflation based on future speculation that gives supporters enough financial evidence to shout loudly about its future. Ironically, the period of free money it purports to be a counterbalance to is what has fueled the tremendous rise in the price of Bitcoin. As a more hawkish Fed tightens its grip on all spending, this age of stimulus forever is swiftly coming to an end. Bitcoin has already failed as a currency. A currency by definition is an efficient stable exchange of value that tracks an weighted basket of goods and services with minimum error. A transaction validation on Bitcoin's ledger takes about 10 minutes. If we have to awkwardly stand in a coffee shop for an extra 10 minutes, just because we are cryptocurrency enthusiasts. How can Bitcoin hope to compete with MasterCard or Visa? Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrency for that matter needs to be quick and safe if it's hoped to be accepted as a legitimate payment mechanism. Second, the price that people pay for goods and services in the actual world are directly related to their take-home pay. Relative to that income, items may either expensive or inexpensive. Because a Lamborghini costs 5 to 6 times the average American salary, it is regarded as being pricey. The value of the currency used to purchase Lamborghini remains largely stable. Price of a currency needs to be largely steady in order for it to function. As a result, in order for people to routinely purchase things with a price in Bitcoin, they must also have a set Bitcoin income. An employer must receive income that is fixed in Bitcoin in order to pay a salary in that currency. Additionally, they need to have their overhead costs fixed in Bitcoin in order to produce and make items that are sold for revenue in Bitcoin. The Delhi Spire of Scalability Problem. I did not make this video to take down Bitcoin because I have some deep hatred for it. I made this video with the sole purpose of having an adult conversation about the future of Bitcoin and cryptocurrency. I currently own a number of cryptocurrencies, therefore I have a lot of stake in blockchain technology and the cryptocurrency market. I simply want everyone to be more mindful of the ways that Bitcoin plunged off a cliff without anyone ever realizing what happened. If you like the video, kindly hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching.